Hello, I am Mr. Bridge. Our channel will focus on the military events of World War II. Before we talk about this history, we need to first learn the basic military symbols, as known as NATO Joint Military Symbology. Okay, let's get started. In order to clearly reflect the categories of various military units on the map, and standardize the size of military units, the NATO Military Organization regulated military symbols in 1999. Among the most common are the following icons: put an X in a rectangle to represent infantry. The two slashes in the logo represent the bullet belts carried by the soldiers. On this basis, we can further classify the functions of infantry. If an anchor is to be added to the infantry, this is the mark of the Marine Corps. If we add a triangle under the infantry logo, we can consider it as a mountain, so it is the symbol of mountain infantry. If you add a wave line under it, it can be regarded as a parachute, so it represents airborne troops. For example, the 82nd and 101st Airborne Divisions of the US Army are both well-known troops. Next, we will see another more common type of unit, the Tank Army. It consists of a rectangle and a rounded rectangle, and we can regard the rounded rectangle in the middle as the tank's continuous track. If we classified the tanks by magnitude, it will have light, medium, heavy, and super heavy tanks. The heavier the magnitude, the thicker the vertical line on the left, as indicated by these symbols. For example, during World War II, the US arsenal produced about 50,000 Sherman medium tanks. In addition, the German Heavy Tiger used to be a major threat for some of the Allied armies. If we combine the symbols of the armor with those of the infantry, that makes up the Panzergrenadier, also known as the mechanized infantry. There is another type of soldier on the map, the motorized soldiers. The motorized infantry has only a vertical line in its symbol. It's two solid circles added to the lower corner of the logo to represent the wheels of the vehicle. We need to note that mechanized infantry and motorized infantry are actually two types of soldiers. The mechanized infantry tends to have strong armor that rides in an infantry fighting vehicle, whereas motorized infantry lacks armor protection and travel primarily on motorcycles. But both of them are far more mobile than normal infantry. The above mentioned are the most basic and common types of army icons. Besides, we often see artillery icons on the map, which made up of a rectangle and a dot. We can regard this dot as a crater left by a cannonball explosion. The medical soldier icon is represented across drawn in the picture to show this field rescue unit. If you remove a line from the infantry symbol, it's the cavalry's trooper's icon, as seen on the map with many Polish cavalry units. At the same time, the high mobility of the cavalry enabled it to escape quickly from enemy fire. So the cavalry icon can also represent a highly mobile scout. If you combine the symbol of a tank with the symbol of a scout, it represents a mechanized scout. Mechanized scouts are consisted of light tanks with high mobility as well as armored vehicles. The last category, the anti-aircraft and anti-tank units, which are represented by a sleek and sharp bulge. The German 88mm anti-aircraft gun, for example, can be used for both anti-aircraft and anti-tank purposes. Now let's move on to the most important part. You'll see several crosses above the icons of each military unit on the map. Two of these crosses represent division-level units, which usually consist of 10,000 to 20,000 men. Three of the crosses represent corps-level units. The army size is usually 30,000 or more. The four crosses represent army units. The number of men is usually above 50,000. The number of people and names of military units of the same rank will be different of some country. For example, the Soviet Union's 3rd Ukrainian Front, which is different from the army group that we use. This table contains all military formations and their corresponding military symbols. You're now familiar with the basic unit categories and how they are represented in the establishment. Next, we are going to apply all that we have learned to military maps. We can see one of the largest icons with five crosses above it. The words indicate its number, the theater of operations to which it belongs, or the duties performed by this unit. That's why it means Northern Army Group. On August 25, 1939, Theodor von Bock was appointed commander of this army group. This army group consisted of the 3rd Army under the command of von Schiller, and the 4th Army under Gunther von Kluge. As just mentioned, the text in the military icon also indicates its function. Just like the 1st Frontier Corps, as shown here, their task was the attack on Danzig in the Polish campaign. Among the formations of the 4th Army, we need to pay attention to the 19th Armored Corporation. The 19th Panzer Corps had the 3rd Panzer Division, as well as the 2nd and 20th Motorized Infantry Divisions. 19th Panzer Corps is under the command of General Guderian. Looking to the south, there is a Southern Army Group headquarter. The group commander is Gerd von Rundstedt. The chief of the general staff is Erich von Manstein. The Southern Theater of Operations has the 8th, 10th, and 14th Armies. Those of you who are well-versed in the history of World War II will note that in the 10th Army Theater of Operations, there was a 2nd Light Panzer Division, which became the Wehrmacht's 7th Panzer Division in France campaign. The commander of the 7th Panzer Division in the French campaign, and also the commander of the African Theater, was the famous General Erwin Rommel. Let's have a look at the Polish Army. Before the outbreak of World War II, the Polish Army was divided into 7 groups, from north to south, namely Pomorski, Modlin, Narew, Poznan, Lodz, Krakow, and Carpathians. In total, Poland mobilized about 1 million men and more than 800 tanks. As you can see from the map, most of the Polish army is made up of infantry, as well as a portion of the cavalry units composed. Here we need to note that the Polish Cavalry Brigade or Division of Cavalry are not all composed of a single cavalry soldiers. A massive Polish cavalry unit, often with a cavalry majority, the rest of the force consists of infantry, artillery, armor, anti-tank, and engineer units. Multi-component joint warfare like this ensures that this force can complement each other's shortcomings on the battlefield and respond to various changes in the war zone. Next, we will look at a couple of famous armies from World War II. We can see 2 very famous American units, 82nd All-American Airborne Division and the 101st Screaming Eagle Airborne Division. We use the wavy line to indicate the Airborne Division, along with 2 crosses. The 82nd Airborne Division was the 1st Airborne Division established in the U.S. Army. Participated with the 101st Airborne Division in the Normandy landings. On top of that, there are 2 excellent units in the infantry field in the U.S. Army. That was the 1st U.S. Army Division, also known as the Big Red One. The other unit, the 442nd Infantry Regiment of the U.S. Army. I'll make a series of videos to tell the story of this 442nd Infantry Regiment. When we talk about the Soviet Union, we have to mention the 62nd Army Group, which was later reorganized as the 8th Guards Group. The commander of the 62nd Army Group is Vasily Chukov. It had commanded the unit to victory in the Battle of Stalingrad. Another Soviet general, Georgi Konstantinovich Zhukov. Operation Leningrad, Moscow. Operation Uranus at the Battle of Stalingrad, as well as the Battle of Kursk, all under his command. We come back to see the Chinese battlefield. On September 1, 1937, the 74th Army of the Republic of China was formed in Zhejiang Province. The later development, continuous accumulation of combat experience, replacement of weapons, and equipment, makes it become one of the most powerful units of the Republic of China. In February 1942, the Republic of China formed the Expeditionary Force. The most famous of these units was the new 38th Division commanded by General Sun Liaoren. In Africa, General Montgomery had commanded the British Army's 7th Armored Division. Victory at the Battle of Alamein in North Africa, turning the war in North Africa around in one fell swoop. Whenever people talk about the German tank ace of World War II, we will mention Michel Wittmann. He served with the Tiger 101st Heavy Armored Battalion and was commander of the 2nd Company. With his tank crew, he set the record for most enemy tanks destroyed in a single day. Now that you can get some familiarity with the Army's military symbols, let's see the border between Germany and Poland. In April 1939, German Army headquarters began drafting plans the invasion of Poland, codenamed Case White. At the end of August 1939, the Germans were assembled in north, west, and south part of Poland, and prepared a million more troops, 6,000 to 9,000 artillery pieces, and over 2,000 aircraft. The war was on the brink. In the next video, we will begin the Battle of Poland. The next video will be uploaded on the English channel. I put the link below. Welcome to subscribe this main channel and the English channel. Thanks for watching this video. See you next time.